The Open Primavera. This is the login form of Primavera. The second one is all databases we created previously. You delete any database by clicking on trash icon. By clicking on these three dots, you see the type of the database and where it is saved. From add, you can create a new database. I explained how to create a new database in a previous lesson. PMDB is a database which we created in a previous lesson. If the database is selected and click on configure, you see we can change the database alias, database type, also configured database address. If we click on finish, the configuration of our new database is finished. I don't want to change anything. I click on cancel and back to database section. Now we back to login. You see the database alias here. It is PMDB. You remember the login name and password of this database. I write it, then connect. Every time you open Primavera, you need to write the login name and password of the database. This is the user interface of P6, and I'm explaining you main user interfaces of Primavera. You can see three windows. The first window is the information on specified items, which we choose from the left toolbar. And these items are defined by columns, and these columns are settable by the user. For example, when I click on projects, the window changes to projects items. You see all the sample projects which are defined by Primavera. In this current screen, you can see project ID, project name, total activities, strategic priority are the default columns of this project. These are definable by the user. The right of the first window, which we call table window, is Gantt chart window. Top of Gantt chart is customizable time scale. At the bottom is the detail window. You can see detail about the selected items from the table window. Here, you can see customizable tabs. You can also change the views by going to View, Show on Top, Show on Bottom. Besides of these tables, you can see toolbars, top, left, right. You can drag each of these toolbars anywhere you want. You can also add or remove any toolbars by right-clicking on toolbars, then you can select any toolbar. With this icon, you can define a new project. All projects that you have defined, you can see with this button. This one is resources. Here we see predefined reports, and we can also define reports according to our project. Here is tracking, where we can get S-curve, see actuals, and planned activities according to resources and materials. This is EPS icon. You see some predefined EPSs. EPS is highest level of organization. For example, EPS name here is ENC, short form of engineering and construction. It means this project is engineering and construction, not procurement or finance. I back to Projects tab and open one of the predefined projects. The first icon is Activities, which is the current tab in Table window. Second is WBS. WBS is short form of Work Breakdown Structure. WBS is the highest level of a work package. For example, in WBS tab, it is Design and Engineering. If I back to Activities, I see the subset of Design and Engineering, WBS, is these five activities. It means, for finishing Design and Engineering WBS, we need to finish first these five activities.